Okay. Show me.
Hi there guys, welcome back to the Dutch channel, thank you very much for tuning in for a video about this FlySky Paladin PL18 radio. It's a new radio from FlySky and it's a step above their usual radios. FlySky is known for their budget radios, I hope that's fair to say, I think it is. Now I just finished shooting my review of this radio. And after I shot that video, it turned out that video is 45 minutes long. Yeah. So I thought, well, maybe not everybody wants to sit through a 45 minute review of this radio. And what I decided to do is lift one piece out of that review into this video here. And that's the section in which I elaborate about who I think this radio is for. If you are looking at this radio online and you wonder, well, is this the radio for me? Is this useful for me? Should I want it? Then, well, I guess this video is especially for you. So that's why I lifted this part of the review out of my full length review. Yeah, I hope you are helped with this condensed part of my review. Here we go. Okay, then on to the hard part of this video. Who do I think this radio is for? This Paladin radio from FlySky. Now, obviously FlySky tries to tell us that this radio is for everybody. And yeah, in theory, most RC pilots could use this radio. But would you want to? First of all, it's not a super duper cheap radio. Right? It costs a couple hundred euros, so it's not for the budget shopper. And also, I wouldn't buy this radio as a first radio. You first want to see if you actually like this hobby, right? So maybe a second radio. But still, even then, it's not a budget proposition, this radio. To that, I should add, by the way, that how long do you use a radio for? Several years? So if you spread the cost of this radio out to, well, a monthly cost, it doesn't really matter all that much what your radio costs, right? You're only buying one. It's not like drones or airplanes. You don't buy a new radio every month. Well, most people don't, at least. Having said that, would this radio be a good option for people that only fly FPV drones or quadcopters? And I mean racing quadcopters or freestyle quadcopters. Well, obviously you can use this radio for such quadcopters, so sure, why not, if you'd really want to. But this radio has so many options, I'd struggle to justify that option. Now, you could argue, well, the radio has super duper precise gimbals and the lag is very low, lower than any radio I've used so far. Maybe the Futaba Fast Thrust systems come close or are equal. And I'm not comparing it to Crossfire simply because I don't have Crossfire. But as a bare radio without a module, so relying on the RF system that comes with the radio, very low latency, very precise gimbals, and so far, yeah, I'm not a long range pilot. But the link quality I've seen so far, it is better than at least the FR Sky radios I've used. Now, let's say you fly RC airplanes and quadcopters, and basically you do all kinds of RC stuff with your radio, like me, basically. I fly airplanes, I even fly helicopters and drones, quadcopters, and I sometimes drive RC boats, then this radio would be brilliant, basically. It's got all the options you need, and yeah, it's super reliable so far. So for that kind of pilot or driver, I'd recommend this radio. Airplane pilots only, I'd say, why not? It's a very dependable radio so far. And yeah, I can't see a reason why our airplane pilots wouldn't enjoy this radio. And the last category I'd see use this radio would be the professional RC user. So people that make ground surveys, or maybe you take photos of properties, or maybe you are in the movie industry. For those kinds of pilots, I can see them using this radio. With this radio, you have a, well, it works well, that's one thing, but also if you show up at a job site with this radio, nobody will think, well, that's a toyish radio. They won't take you not seriously because of the gear you're using. Hope that makes any sense. And that's basically, yeah, the user groups. Again, if you only fly FPV racing drones, meh. Personally, I'd want a smaller radio with fewer knobs and switches. If you fly airplanes, then yes, great radio. Helicopters, probably as well. One thing I should add to that is that the radio isn't really useful for pinchers, in my humble opinion. Yeah, this radio is really designed for thumb flyers. So you should take that into account as well. So again, that was my who is it for part of the review of this FlySky Paladin PL-18 radio. Again, I hope this was useful for you. If you are, however, left with questions, don't hesitate to ask. Catch you on the next video. Bye bye.